Okay, best life regression using video. This is how I would do it if I were going to do it. I can't recommend that you do it. I can't ask you to do this. And if you do this using this video, use it at your own risk. And disclaimer, right? Don't do this if you think you should be doing this with a trained facilitator. Okay, enough said. Now, first I'm going to share with you the internal thinking of the person coached, me, while the facilitator gives the questions. Okay, and then in the second half of this video or in the next video, I'm going to actually give myself the questions with the video and answer them. Okay, it goes like this. All right. Rich? Yeah? What I'd like you to do is locate a particular kind of incident. It's relatively specific, so we don't splatter your attention all over your time track. Okay, we don't want to get something vague like a time you were having fun, because although you might find one incident, you can get several incidents coming together of you were having fun, and when you try to run one incident from beginning to end, you end up, you know, jumping into the other incident, and they get confused in consciousness. That's one thing to remember. Now, when I ask you to locate an incident, it's going to be specific. So we are going to work in this demonstration a time you were on a spacecraft with friends having fun. Now, I'm going to ask you that question because in order to get a past life experience, it is necessary to be specific, to keep it, so this doesn't blow up in your face, buddy. You want to keep it as specific as possible. So I'm going to do a time you were on a spacecraft, because most people that are watching this sort of thing have some kind of spiritual growth and awareness thing going with themselves and be looking at past life regression type videos and stuff. They will probably have had a past life experience while in a spacecraft. Just from my experience, that's the way it works. Because most of us, we weren't from here in the first place, and we came here in different ways, and some of us came on spacecrafts. Okay, so it's a good bet as a demonstration. So I'm going to be asking you that question. Now, when I ask you that question, Rich, you know, spot a time you were, or locate a time you were having fun on a spacecraft with friends. Now, when I ask you that question, when I ask you that question, I want you to take the first thing that flashes into your head. Don't be analytical about it. Don't think about it. Don't nothing. Just you get an image will pop up. Just maybe a fleeting image. Just grab it. Take it. Go with it. Okay? Can you do that? Yeah, I can do that. Okay, good. All right, now, another thing is, let's see, when I'm going to locate an incident of a time you were in a spacecraft having fun with friends. We're doing a pleasure moment because we don't want to get into your stuff. Normally, the past life regression work that I've done and that I do helps relieve traumatic incidents, trauma, emotional trauma. And the way the subconscious mind works, that's where we store all of our trauma. So it's a delicate operation here, Rich, to stay in the positive in pleasure moments. I know. Now, this choking, coughing thing, this is actually an emotional reaction subconsciously already, this dealing with this material. I know this from experience. It's not just I accidentally something, you know. No, this is part of the stuff. So it's already biting. And this is me staying focused on a positive experience. So I'm just saying, once again as a disclaimer, this is research, and I would do this with someone with a written disclaimer, okay? So this is just for demonstration purposes only, and don't do this without a trained facilitator and all that, okay? All right, now, Rich, after I ask you to locate this incident, I'm going to ask you to move to it. Move in consciousness to it, shift to it, focus on it. And what this does, it takes you in consciousness and moves your time track, and you're there. Rich, you got that? I go, yeah, I got that. Now, it happens instantly. It's automatic. You don't have to, like, let me move there, you know. No, I say move to that instant, boom, you're there. You will get an instant impression or visual image or auditory, you'll get something. You're there. And so then you just let me know that you're there. Okay. Just say, I'm there. Or just say, I'll go move to the beginning of that incident, the time you were on a spacecraft with friends having fun. Okay, I'm there. You'll get something. Something will shift in your consciousness. Okay, I'm there. And then I will say, good. And then I will ask you what you perceive. You will see something, feel something. You have some impressions, emotional responses. You'll get something, and I'll ask you what that is. And then I'm going to ask you how long the incident lasted. And this is when you kind of look. You look both, it seems like a couple hours. So you're going to go, and you'll tell me a couple hours. And then I'll have you move back to the beginning of the incident, and I'll have you move through the incident, run the incident for that two-hour duration. And then you do, and I'll be quiet while you do that. And then you tell me what happened. I'll ask you. When you're done, you let me know. And you go, okay, I'm done. I went through it. And you can tell me what happened. And sometimes you might want to tell me what's happening as you're going through it. Well, I'm with friends. It seems like a celebration. Somebody looks like a job promotion. And, like that. And I will also be asking you, what determined the end of the experience? And you go, well, everybody left. We all went back to work. We went home. Or it left. It ended for me before it ended for everybody else, because I left with this girl and we went off and started another experience. Okay. With friends on a spacecraft, right? So anyway, so there's that. And once you get through it and get done, Rich, I'm going to ask you what happened, and then I'm going to ask you to go through the incident again. And so we go through it several times. More and more content comes up. You talk about it. And this is, it's not simple. This is your past life regression. This is how it works. Now, when we do real stuff, real serious stuff with a facilitator, and you normally deal with emotionally charged material, because that's the whole point, really, of the kind of past life regression work I do, is to go back in time and release the earliest time you can of a particular kind of aberration or a particular kind of emotional problem, issue, thing, and it releases and you feel better. So that's the point. Okay. So we go through the incident a few times, and then we go to an earlier similar one. That's the way it works. That's it. Simple as that. Okay, now, here we go. In the next video, in the next video, I'm going to say, watch this video first. And then the next video, I'm going to do a example session. And in the next video after that, I'm going to do the commands only. So that I can use the command video and give myself a session using the command video. It's all research. Will it work? I don't know. It might not work at all. It might not work for Zip because of some phenomena that needs to be, there with a live facilitator. But it might work, and that's why it's research. Okay, so there it is. And don't do this yourself. This is just for educational purposes only. Okay. I'll talk to you later. Originally, in earlier videos, I said, this I'm going to make this for you guys to do on your own. But I realized, from a disclaimer point of view, that, I don't know. Maybe, I shouldn't be recommending people do this. Why? I don't know. But anyway, this is just for demonstration purposes only now. Change my mind. Don't do this.